Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. This is the concluding video of Katha Upanishad. This video tells us how to attain happiness in life through cessation of desire and by practicing yoga. But before that, a word about Upanishads, which are magnificent movements of ancient Indian wisdom, writes Sunil Daman, being the grand outpourings of the spiritual experience of those unique seekers of truth who, having risen above the chaos of ritualism and world spinning of scholastic philosophy, saw the truth directly through intuitive insights and thus gave the thinking world what no philosophy based merely on logical reasoning could possibly give. The aim of the authors in writing these scriptures was not, however, so much propagation of their metaphysical findings as to bring peace and freedom to anxious and struggling humanity through right living based on spiritual experiences. Katha Upanishad has a fabulous story built into it. Nachiketa, a young human being, dies and reaches the house of Yama, the god of death, and there he sits for a few days without food, without water. When Yama arrives, he is sorry that his guest has not taken any food or water. So he asks him to ask for three boons. The third boon Nachiketa asks for is this: tell me, Yama, what happens after death? Now Yama says, you take any boons, you can be sent back to the earth and be with your father, etc., etc. You can get any amount of money, wealth, jewelry, palaces, but this question don't ask. But Yama, Nachiketa says, no, I am going to ask this question again and again. Yama answers this question in so many different ways, which I have been discussed in the earlier videos. The essence of his answer is this, that the life on this earth is important, and with death everything ceases. But in life you can be happy, you can reach your Atman, that is the soul, which is the cosmic soul, which is the same as individual soul. And in this particular section of the Canto, Yama tells Nachiketa that cessation of desire is paramount to be happy in this world. And this can be achieved by meditating upon the Atman and practicing yoga. I shall now take up verses one by one and explain to you their meaning and their significance. Actually, Yama is showing us a path how to live. In the earlier video, we had said that life itself is an achievement. So let us live it fully, happily, by doing good to ourselves. At this stage, Yama makes a very sound observation. He says, knowing that the senses are distinct from the Atman and their rising and setting separate from the Atman, a wise man grieves no more, because with death only the senses come to an end, the Atman does not. Indriya nama prithak bhavam udaya tamayo cha yat prithak guptadya mana nam matva dhiro na shochati. A wise man grieves no more. So Nachiketa, don't worry, don't ask me this question about death. Wise men don't grieve. Further, Yama says, higher than the senses is the mind. Higher than the mind is the intellect. Higher than the intellect is the great Atman. Higher than Atman is the unmanifested. Beyond the unmanifested is the all-pervading and imperceptible Purusha. By knowing him, the mortal is liberated and attains immortality. So know yourself. Know that Purusha hidden within you. Realize. Don't think that you are going to Swargalok and live the life of a lichar, or you would be served with great food. All that ends here. The happiness in this world is the happiness of life. Get it. Yama's observation that no one can see him with the eye is important. The Atman is perceived only by the heart, by the intellect, by the mind. He moves on to say, now this is a description of death also partly, when the five organs of perception become still together with the mind and the intellect ceases to be active, that is called the highest state. That is meditation, where all thinking processes stop. Five organs of perception become still. Remarkable words. And the mind too, the intellect too. And there you have achieved it. You have attained to the Atman through meditation. This firm holding back of the senses, tam yogamiti manyate sthirim indriya dharanam, that is what is known as yoga. This is the definition of yoga which the whole world practices today. Then one should become watchful, for yoga comes and goes. So you have to be persistent. Naivo vacha na manasa praptum shakyo na chakshusha astiti bruvato anyatra katham tat upalabhyate. He cannot be attained by speech or by the eye. How can that be realized except by him who says he is? It's an affirmation of Atman. He should be realized as he is, and also as the reality of both visible and invisible. He who knows him as he is, to him alone his real nature is revealed. Now, how to attain this state of mind? Yama says, yada sarve pramuchyante kama ye asya hridishrita ath martyo amrito bhav trayatra brahma samushnate. When all desires dwelling in the heart cease, then the mortal becomes immortal and attains Brahman here. This is a message given in Gita. This is a message from Buddha. Let the desires cease. Vasna chodo, ichha chodo. Swikar karo jo kuch hai usi ko. Vasna se takleef hoti hai. Hum dusron pe zulm karte hain. Yama says, when all the ties of the heart are cut asunder, then the mortal becomes immortal. Such is the teaching. Yama says, the Purusha, the inner self, is ever seated in the heart of all living beings. With perseverance, man should draw him out from his body, as one draws the inner stalk from a blade of grass. One should know him as pure and deathless, as pure and deathless. This is the wisdom Yama says, I have given you, Nachiketa. We get all together with the rules of yoga. You become free from impurity and death and attain Brahman. And not only you, Yama says, so also will it be with another who likewise knows the nature of the self. At the end of the Upanishad is repeated the agreement between a teacher and the taught. Sahana vavatu, sahanau bhunaktu, sahaviryam karvabahi, tejasvina bhadhitamastu, ma vidvishabahi. May he, the Supreme Being, protect us both. May he be pleased with us. May we acquire strength. May our study bring us illumination. May there be no enmity amongst us. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Let there be peace. Peace in everything, as stated in Shanti Path, which is repeated by all of us at the end of any meditation. Om Deu Shanti Antariksham, Shanti Prithvi, Shanti Rapaha, Shanti Roshadhaya, Shantir Vanaspataya, Vishwe Deva Shanti, Shanti Brahma, Shanti Sarvam, Shanti Reva Shanti, Sama Shanti, Shanti Redhi, Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. May there be peace in the skies, in the waters, on the earth, in the products we make, in human beings, even peace within peace. It's a fantastic idea. Shanti Reva Shanti. Let there be peace in our wisdom, in our thinking. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Today we end the Katha Upanishad. I shall take up another Upanishad in my next video, and I hope you would visit and listen to me. Here is wisdom of ancient India. Here is wisdom which is applicable to all situations. Here is wisdom for peace of mankind and for spiritual elevation of human beings. Thank you very much.